बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। 10th क्लास मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 1 क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, चैप्टर नंबर 2 क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। एंड टुडे वी स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 2.2। एंड इन एक्सरसाइज 2.2 वी डिस्कस अबाउट द quadratic equations. Before we start the exercise 2.2, let's discuss about the some topics which we have discussed in 2.1. So first of all, we discuss about the discriminant and nature of the roots. We know that what is the standard form of the quadratic equation. Standard form of the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, and we know that what are the roots of the quadratic equation. We have two roots of the quadratic equation. First root is minus b plus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a, and other is minus b minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Okay, now how we check the nature of the roots. For the nature of the roots, we only need to discuss about the b square minus 4ac, which is written inside the square root, okay, and which is called the discriminant. Okay, now nature of the roots. If we have four cases in nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. Now, case number one. Case number one is if b square minus 4ac greater than 0 and is a perfect square, then the roots are rational and unequal. Perfect square means, let's suppose our answer is 49. And we know that 49 is the perfect square of the 7. So that's why we can say that now our roots are rational and unequal. Case number 2. If b square minus 4ac greater than 0 and not a perfect square, then the roots are irrational and unequal. Okay, let's take an example. Let's suppose our answer is 35. And we know that 35 is not the perfect square, because there is no number. When we take the square of that number, we get 35. So that's why our roots are irrational. Case number 3. If b square minus 4 is equal to 0, then the roots are rational and equal. Okay. So let's suppose if we get our answer 0, so roots are real and equal. And last case, case number 4, if b square minus 4ac less than 0, then the roots are imaginary or complex. So let's start the exercise 2.1. So in exercise 2.1, we have question number 1. Find the discriminant of the following given quadratic equation. And we have part number 1. 2x square plus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. So first of all, we write the equation 2x square plus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. Now compare it with the standard form of the quadratic. And we know that the standard form of the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now a is 2, b is 3, and c is 1, minus 1. So d, I, s, c. In all the question, we only write d, I, s, c dot. It's mean whenever we write d, I, s, c dot, it's mean it is discriminant. And we know that it is equals to b square minus 4ac. Now simply we put the values. B is 3, minus 4, a is 2, and c is minus 1. So our answer is 17. As we know that 17 is greater than 0 and 17 is not the perfect square. So our roots are irrational and unequal. Okay? Part number 2. Okay, now 6x square minus 8x plus 3 equal to 0. In this question, we have 6x square minus 8x plus 3. Now compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation. So a is 6, b is minus 8, and c is 3. Now, when we use the formula b square minus 4ac, so we simply put the values of b, a, and c. B is minus 8 is 64. 4, 3 is 12. 12, 6 is 72. 64 minus 72 is minus 8. Now, our answer is minus 8, which is less than 0. So, our roots are imaginary and complex. Okay? Roots are imaginary and complex. Part number 3. 9x square minus 30x plus 5 equal to 0. So 9x square minus 30x plus 25 equal to 0. Compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation. So b square minus 4ac. B is minus 30 minus 4. A is 4, C is 25. And when we multiply, 30 square is 90. 4 multiply 4, 16. 16 multiply 25, 900. So 900 minus 900 is 0. So our discriminant is 0. Now part number 4. 4x square minus 7x minus 2 equal to 0. Okay, again, we compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation. And we know that, what is the standard form of the quadratic equation? The standard form of the quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. A is 4, b is minus 7, and c is minus 2. Okay, now when we put the values of a, b, and c, so minus 7 square is 49, 4 4 is 16, 16 2 is 32, minus minus plus. So 49 plus 32 is 81, which is your required answer of the part number 4. In question number 2, find the nature of the roots of the following given quadratic equations and verify the result by solving the equations. In question number 2, our first step is find the discriminant. Then according to discriminant, we have to decide what is the nature of the roots. Third step is verify our results by solving the equations. Okay, now start the part number 1. X square minus 23x plus 20 equal to 0. So part number 1, first of all, we have to compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation, which is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Okay, here a is 1, b is minus 23, and c is 120. Now, the formula b square minus 4ac. B is minus 23. Minus 23 square is 529. And 4 multiply 120 is 480. So, 529 minus 480 is 49. We know that 49 is the perfect square of the 7. So our answer is perfect square. So we can write as the discriminant is greater than 0 and it is perfect square. Therefore, the roots are rational and unequal. Now, our last step, third step, verification by solving the equation. So equation is x square minus 23x plus 20. We have to factorize this equation. And when we factorize this equation, we have to find two numbers. If we multiply them, we must get 120. And if we add them, we must get minus 23. So minus 15 and minus 8. Now we take the common x, so it becomes x minus 15. And from next, these two terms, we take the common minus 8, so it becomes x minus 15. When we take the x minus 15 common, because we know that in these two terms, we have x minus 15 common, so we get here x minus 8. So x minus 8 multiply x minus 15 equal to 0. X minus 8 equal to 0, x minus 15 equal to 0. So we get two answers, x equal to 8 and x equal to 15. So thus the roots are rational and unequal. Okay, because we know that 8 and 15, these both numbers are rational and they are unequal because 8 and 15 are not equal to 0. So let's start the part number 2. 2x square plus 3x plus 7 equal to 0. So first of all, compare with the standard form of the quadratic equation. A is 2, B is 3, and C is 7. Now simply we put the values. So B, 3. 3 square is 9. 4 2s are 8. 8 7 is 56. 9 minus 56 is minus 47, which is less than 0. So our discriminant is less than 0 and negative. Therefore, the roots are imaginary and unequal. So verify answer by solving the quadratic equation. So we use the quadratic formula. Minus b plus minus square root b minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Simply put the values. And when we put the values, minus 3 plus minus, simply you can write the answer of discriminant, because we know that b square minus 4ac is equal to discriminant, and which is equal to minus 47. Now minus 3 plus minus square root minus 47 divided by 4, which is your answer. And we know that minus 3 plus minus square root minus 47 divided by 4 is the complex roots. And we can say that is the imaginary roots. Okay, so we verify our answer. Now, part number 3, 16x square minus 24x plus 9 equal to 0. Again, in this part, first of all, we have to compare with standard form of the quadratic equation. And when we compare this with the standard form of the quadratic equation, we get a equal to 16, b equal to minus 24, and c equals to 9. Put the values of a, b, c. So minus 24 square is 576. 4 multiply 16. 4 multiply 16 is 64. And 64 multiply 9 is 576. Now 576 minus 576 is 0. So in this question, as we discriminant is equal to 0, so therefore the roots are real and equal. Now we have to verify our answers. Whenever we have our answer equal to 0, so it means roots are equal. So what do you mean by roots are equal? Roots are equal means, in quadratic equation, we know that we have two roots. Okay. Whenever we have linear equation, so we have only one root. When we have quadratic equation, so we have two roots. When we have cubic equation, we have three roots. When we have biquadratic equations, we have four roots. It means in quadratic equation, we have two roots. And whenever we have a statement, the roots are equal, it means the both roots are equal. Let's suppose if we have the x1 equals to 5. So x2 is also equal to 5. Okay. Now, 16x square minus 24x plus 9 equal to 0. Using the quadratic formula, minus b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a, simply put the values of a, b, and c. When we put the values, so it becomes minus into minus 24, which is the value of b, plus minus square root, b is minus 24. minus 24 whole square minus 4, a is 16 and c is 9. 16 multiplied 4 is 64. And 64 multiplied 9 is 576. And minus 24 square is 576. 576 minus 576 is equal to 0. So square root 0 is nothing, 0. So 24 divided by 32. When we cancel 24 and 32 with the help of 6th table or a table, we can divide the 24 with the help of 8, it becomes 3. And when we divide the 32 with the help of 8, it becomes 4. So 3 over 4 is your required answer. Now, part number 4. In part number 4, 3x square plus 7x minus 13 equal to 0. So, first of all, we have to compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation. Okay. So, when we compare this with the standard form of the quadratic equation, we get a equal to 3, b equal to 7, and c equal to minus 13. So, now put the values of a, b, c in the discriminant. So, it becomes b square minus 4ac and b is 7, 7 square is 49. 4, a is 3, c is minus 13, 4 3s are 12, 12 multiplied 13 is 156, and this minus minus plus. So, 49 plus 156 is 205. As we know that 205 is positive and greater than 0. So, our roots are unequal, but 205 is not the perfect square. So, our roots are irrational and unequal. Now, verify our results by solving the equation. So, we use the quadratic formula simply. Put the values of a, b, c. And when we put the values of a, b, c, so minus 7 plus minus 7 square minus 4 multiplied 3 minus 13. We know that it becomes 205 as we solve as a discriminant. So, minus 7 plus minus square root 205 divided by 6. These are the irrational and unequal. Okay. Now, there is a small and important point between the question number 4 and question number 3. What is the difference between minus 7 plus minus square root 205 divided by 6 and in part number 2, minus 3 plus minus square root minus 47 divided by 4? Okay? So, what is the main difference? In part number 2, we say that our roots are imaginary and complex. But in part number 4, we say that our roots are irrational and real. Why we don't say here our roots are imaginary or complex? Why? Any student? Because there is a simple and small logic. If you see carefully in part number 4, we have minus 7 plus minus square root 205. We can find the square root of 205. Okay? We can find the square root of 205. When you write in the calculator square root of 205, so it gives you some answer. It gives you 14.317. But in question number 2, when you write the square root minus 47, it don't give you any answer. Any answer. Because we don't solve minus within the square root. Whenever we have square root within the, when we have minus within the square roots, so we write iota. As we know that, we learn in the 9th class mathematics books, chapter number 2, exercise 2.5, and question number 4. I hope now you understand. And we also done this type of question in 9th class mathematics books, chapter number 2, exercise 2.6 and question number 4, part number, question number 2 and part number 4. Okay, so that is the reason why we say that in part number 2 imaginary roots and in part number 4 we have irrational roots. Okay, so now start the question number 3. For word value of k, the expression is perfect square. It means we have to find the value of k, and we know that the expression is the perfect square. Okay, so first of all we compare it with the standard form of the quadratic equation. So a is k square and b is 2 multiply k plus 1 and c is 4. So discriminant, put the value of b. 2 square is 4. So k plus 1 whole square minus 4, 4 is 16, k square. Here we apply the formula a plus b whole square. A square plus 2ab plus b square. So when we multiply 4 within the bracket, it becomes 4k square plus 8k plus 4 minus 16k square. When we simplify this step, it becomes minus 12k square plus 8k plus 4 equal to 0. As we know that the discriminant of the given expression is the perfect square, therefore the roots are rational and equal. So we take the discriminant equal to 0. Now we multiply minus, or you can say that we take the minus common. So it becomes 12k square minus 8k minus 4 equal to 0. Now we have to do factorization. So 12 multiply 4, 48. We have to find two numbers. If we multiply them, we get 48. And if we add them, we must get minus 8. So those numbers are 12 and 4. So minus 12 and plus 4. From these two terms, we have to take common 12k. Remaining is k minus 1. From next, these two terms, we take common 4. It becomes k minus 1. And when we take the common k minus 1, we get 12k plus 4. Okay, now 12k plus 4 equal to 0 and k minus 1 equal to 0. When we take minus 1 from the left hand side to right hand side, it becomes plus 1. So k equal to 1. And when we take plus 4 to the right hand side, it becomes minus 4. And when we divide 12 to the right hand side, it becomes minus 4 over 12. Cancel with the help of table 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 threes are 12. So k equals to minus 1 over 3, which is your required answer of the question number 3. Now, if you have any problem, any question related to our today's topic and lecture, you can text me. I am here to solve your problems and your questions, but only related to today's topic.